Hello and welcome. My name is Jeffrey Kennedy and welcome back to another episode of Elliott Wave Junctures. When looking for a high probability trade setup or looking for an opportunity in a financial market, it's very important that you're clear on what you're looking for. And that's exactly what Elliott Wave Junctures is designed to do. It's to teach you exactly what to look for. Now, with respect to this price chart right here, and with respect to the wave principle, it's very important to understand a few of the wave patterns. And actually, don't even need to understand a few of the wave patterns if you understand the modalities. Okay, now, if we start big picture and work our way down, there are specifically 13 different individual wave patterns of the wave principle. Well, if you take out variations, there's essentially five, okay? Five wave patterns. Impulse waves, ending diagonals, flats, zigzags, and triangles. Now, if you break those patterns down into their individual modalities, you have motive waves and corrective waves. If that's all you can do is simply understand the difference between impulse waves and corrective waves, you're light years ahead of the rest. Okay, now what's the one of the distinguishing characteristics between motive waves and corrective waves? Okay, well, an impulse wave or a motive wave, and let me fix my little crayon here on the price chart so it's a little bit clearer to see. There we go. Okay, now with respect to a wave pattern, or specifically impulse waves, one of the key characteristics is that the moves do not overlap. Waves 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I know within an ending diagonal you actually expect wave 4 to end in the price territory of wave 1, and that in and of itself is a trading opportunity because essentially in this type of a pattern you're looking for a move to the downside. But what I really want to focus on primarily for today's lesson is actually that move that right there, the impulse move. The impulse wave, again, it's easily discernible because the moves don't overlap. That's why wave 4 cannot end in the price territory of wave 1. Okay, well, corrective waves, well, they tend to be choppy, sloppy, and slow, and tend to be contained by parallel lines. So if you see something like this, a three-wave move, well, that's most likely a zigzag. And then if you continue to see the overlap within the structure, well, then we're looking at a corrective combination, a WXY pattern, or possibly even a double zig. All of this is very important because if the waves overlap, as they do here, odds are it's a counter trend move. If waves do not overlap as it is here, then what you're most likely working with is an impulse wave. Let me show you exactly where I'm trying to go with all this. If we look at this price chart in front of us, which is the ruble, and let me clean the price chart up a little bit, what you'll notice with respect to this is that the advance from this extreme here up into the high is that the move overlaps, okay? More importantly, there's seven waves, and what I mean by that is we have waves A, B, C, X, A, B, C. More specifically, this is the picture I see from an Elliott wave perspective. So that means that this is a countertrend move. This could be a wave B, this could be a wave X, but most importantly, it's a countertrend move. And once complete, it will be more than fully retraced, as it was, as you can see in the subsequent months that followed. Okay, why is this important? Well, let me show you another market. And as you know, I'm also the editor of Futures Junctures. And here's a market that we've been looking at recently. And this is an ETF of sugar. And again, if you look at the advance from the December 2011 low to the extreme that we've recently seen, well, what are the similarities and the characteristics of the prior slide, i.e. the ruble? Well, number one, we have overlap with respect to the substructures. Okay, now in this instance here, this example, we don't have the nice, clean, clear example of this corrective move being contained within parallel lines, but what we do have are waves A, B, C, X, A, B, C. In other words, the advance in the ETF of sugar, ticker symbol SGG, it is not this. This is an impulse wave. Okay, well, if this formation in sugar in the SGG is not this, then that means it's a countertrend move, and in the weeks ahead will be more than fully retraced. Again, one thing I encourage you to do at minimum with respect to the understanding the wave principle, begin by understanding the difference between motive waves and corrective waves. With respect to motive waves, there's two types, impulse waves and ending diagonals. With respect to corrective waves, you have three basic patterns, flats, zigzags, and triangles. If you can understand the difference between the two, you can identify high probability trade setups on any time frame and in any market. Thank you very much, and have a